never get confused by professor's explanation. Create your own simplified explanation because your cache memory is limited. Now, how? Because you know, when I studied this SAS, I was like utterly confused by the concept. You know, these professors try to explain the same ways in which books are telling, but never go by them. For example, they tried to make us memorize these equations, these formulas. Let me tell you. And people were so happy remembering also. For example, just see these three equations. This is Laplace, this is Fourier, this is Z transform. All are nothing but inner product, inner product, inner product. Now, why do they say all? Why can't they say that all these different spaces are clubbed together? They are simply, they can make the crunch, these concepts merge, and in some space, they can do memory saving, they can do compression. This is very important point, okay, which you should understand. They are nothing but inner products. They are all but the spaces in which we are trying to find inner product. For example, we take this. Like we are told that we are always told to remember that j omega times f of omega has inverse Fourier transform df by dt. The inverse Laplace transform of s times f of s is again df by dt. So then how the heck are we going to remember all this? Instead of this, why can't we just simply take the formula f of omega just in mind? Remember what is the formula of inverse Fourier transform, Fourier transform. At least this much we might remember. F of omega 1 by 2 pi e raised to the power j omega t d omega. And just try to derivate it by dt. If you do the derivative by dt, all our d omega, f of omega, they won't be affected. Just this part will be affected. What will come in the front? J omega. So j omega times the remaining part of it. 1 by 2 pi times f of omega. This part was nothing but f of t. I took this d by dt both the sides, okay? I took the d by dt both the sides. If I take the derivative this side, only this j omega is coming and the rest is remaining the same. J omega t d omega. So this part, this rest part, can't I again write it as? So in that sense, this j omega times, if I take this j omega inside, that means that j omega times f of omega has inverse Fourier transform of t by dt of ft. As simple as that. Similarly, for the inverse Laplace transform f of s e raised to the power st, if you just derivate it by time, then simply s times f of s, because when I derivate it by time, this s part is only left. S times f of s is inverse Laplace transform as df by dt. So as simple as that. Just try to mathematically derivate it. Just try to think in mind that if I derivate this e raised to the power st, because I have found some equation, just do it in mind and just remember. So if you don't get, just don't rely on, never rely on rote equations which are redundant, okay? Don't try to remember everything, just try to remember how we did this. That is more enough. The conceptual derivation, this conceptual idea of how we derived, is more important than actually this stuff. Okay?